Good morning, video world. I'm back. I'm going to show, I talked about the air shifter. I'm going to attempt to show actually how easy it is to set up, and I'm going to show the placement of where I put the air tank, everything, the pump, everything. And I'm going to go through the electronics. I'm going to show on a bike that's already been set up and run, which is Janie's bike. It's already been set up, run, tested. It works perfect. I'm going to show the placement of everything. And then I'm going to go through a detailed on this other new bike that doesn't have it on it yet and show you all the components needed, show you, tell you where to get the components from. Try to give you a good idea of how to do it. Now, if you don't have any mechanical experience and also dealing with, this is very small electrical. If you don't have any experience, please just don't be trying to save money. Just take it to whatever performance, center is in your, just close to you, and just have them do it. Just have them put on a air shifter. You have to have a little bit of electrical knowledge, and you definitely have to have some mechanical knowledge, but I'm going to do the best I can to show you how to do it, but you're going to have some knowledge. So needless to say, I'll be right back, and I'll start showing exactly how to set one of them up. All right, video world, as you can see, I've got one bike to strip down. What I'm going to do is on this strip down bike, I'm going to show you basically where to mount everything. And I'm going to show you where to hook up the solenoid to the horn, factory harness wire. And, I'll show you the placement of where everything basically needs to go to set it up. And I'm talking basically for a street bike, a bike that somebody's gonna ride around on the street and have an air shifter on it. So here's the same system. It's set up on Janie's bike. Here's an air gauge. And of course, the hidden things that you won't see on a bike that's already set up is there's air lines that's going to run. So that's the air gauge. These are things that you're going to need to set up an air shifter. Air gauge, so you know how much air pressure. Shifter plunger. Shifter solenoid. And as you can see, the plunger is hooked to the shift lever with a clevis. Okay, you're going to need a, on the other side, which, let me go ahead and actually, I put under here, I think we can get it on here. Might not be able to see it, but under this, under the fairing, I don't think that we're going to be able to see it. Under the fairing on this side, I have, is it this side or? Yeah, it's this side. Under the fairing on that side, and actually, I think I might be able to get up under there and see it. Let me stick this up under there, because I want you to see, I didn't want buttons and all different type of stuff sticking out where people could see it. So let me, well, I don't think that I'm, there it is. See that momentary switch right there? That's the momentary switch. When you press it, hear the air pump. So I have an onboard air pump on here. It just makes it easier. Bracket racing. You don't have to worry about someone coming and having to, you know, with a air tank to air up the system. So that's a momentary switch. And there's an air pump on this bike. Now I'm going to show you where the air pump is. And I'm going to show you where the air tank is. And as you can see, it's hidden on this bike. And it everything fits perfectly. Then I'm going to show you the components that I used. And I'm going to tell you where I purchased those components at. So let me get over here and find that button again. Hit that. I'm going to press that momentary switch. And if you look right there, hidden right there, there's the air pump. There's the air pump. I've got it hidden in there, but if you can see my finger, I'm touching the air pump. So basically, when I took the rear panel off, the rear cowling, I have enough room to mount an air pump in there. And when you take that rear cowling off, when I hit that air pump, as you can see, just by touching it a few times, it's going to raise my air pressure up. So now that means I have air in the, a little bit of air in the system. Well, where that air is being stored at is, if you look under the cowling right here, see that little silver, there's a silver tank right there. There's the air tank right there. It's hidden inside this panel. That air tank is hidden under this panel. It fits perfectly in there. And I'll show you the air tank. I'll tell you where to order it. I'll tell you where to order the pump from. I'll tell you where to order the shifter solenoid, the shifter plunger. And I'll tell you where you can get it all in a kit. And actually, I might as well do that right now. So let me run through that again. This is all you need for an air shifter. On basically a street bike, and to have it self-contained where you can use it anytime you want to because you have your own air pump built in and you have your own catch tank for the air. When we go to race bikes, we normally buy a swing arm with a tank built into the swing arm. But on a street bike just like this right here, it's simple to just have your air gauge here. You have your shifter plunger. You have your shifter solenoid. That's hooked to your shifter lever with a clevis. Okay, so when that air comes out of that tank, you press the horn button because it's hooked up through your horn system. Press the horn button, that releases that air from this solenoid into the shift cylinder. That air then pulls up the shifter lever, shifts it into the next gear. So here's the placement of it. Again, once again, have your air gauge, your air solenoid, your plunger, hidden in the back here, that is my air pump. Hidden on the other side, that's my air tank. Now, I'm gonna show you all these components now on the floor. And of course, you gotta realize now there's airline that's run through the motorcycle to hook all these components together. And there is a small amount of electrical hookups that you have to do. So That's why I say, if you don't understand it, I'm going to do the best I can to show you. You understand and see the setup now, basically on a stock bike. And I could take and put, say, the cowling back on this bike now. And basically, I can go out and ride this bike on the street all day long, anywhere I want to. And if I decide to use the air shifter, just reach back, pump up my compressor. I'll see the compressor pumping up on the motorcycle. Get whatever poundage that you want or use. Some people use 120. I don't use that much. I normally use about 80 pounds. And mine's, these bikes are shifted fine. I go with the less pressure on the system, the better the system is. The better the system is put together, the better it will hold air. And as you can see, when I started off the video, I was up in Iowa. This system had probably some air in it when I left Iowa, and it was still holding air. And it is, I left Iowa on Saturday. No, correction, Sunday. And it is now Thursday morning, and my system on this bike still had air in it. Now, me personally, I normally like the system to leak down like that. That's why, so that the bike is not sitting there when we're not racing it, and it's sitting there and it's got 100 pounds of air in it, pressed up against the actually shift solenoid. So there is a little red button that's on the top of the shift solenoid that you can press. So I'll just show, well, it doesn't, ain't gonna make a difference. You might be able to hear it. If you press that little red button, it'll let off air at the same time it's trying to shift the solenoid, shift the shifter ladder. But you can drain all the air out the system that way. Normally, I don't do it. Normally, matter of fact, I don't do it at all. I know that my systems, I like when I leave just a little bit of leak down so that in 3 or 4 days, if I had 100 pounds of air in there, I know in 3 or 4 days that poundage is going to leak off. And I like it to sit there with zero if I'm not using a bike. So long story short, though, we're getting to what we need to do now. Now, I'm going to show you the components that is needed to put an air shifter system on a motorcycle. You're going to need some line. You're going to need a tank. I've got two different types of tanks. Okay. Both of those tanks, either one of them, will fit in the back of this cowling on this motorcycle. This bottle tank is the most used. And of course, there is a valve that sits on top of it, and you hook two lines in it. And that runs, it runs from when the pump pumps, it pumps in, pumps up the bottle. The other line is hooked to your shifter solenoid, which now you can see this stuff off of the motorcycle. The other line's hooked to your shifter solenoid, just like that line is there. And as you can see, that T, this T is running to your shifter solenoid. This piece of the line here is probably more or less running back to the pump. This piece of line here was running out to the shifter gauge or your air gauge that's up front. And then you have another line that's going to run in, and it'll run to the catch tank. So that, and there's two valves for the catch tank. One for where the pump pumps in, the other where it goes out into the system. Okay. Now, you can order all these components. And like I say now, I don't endorse. I'm not getting paid by these people. These people, I know it as Snitch Racing. They probably don't even know who I am. So a long story short, Snitch doesn't pay me. I don't know them. They, and like that, they probably have no idea who I am. So, but I use their components because they're quick to ship it. Their prices is reasonable. And they'll package the items that you need in nice little packages like this. And you just go online, go to Snitch Racing. Like I say, Dave Snitch, the owner, he probably has no idea who I am. And they don't pay me. I'm not in, I guess I could say, I'm not really endorsing their product. For I don't care what you use or who you use. It doesn't make me any difference. But I use them because I can get the order fast. And they normally package everything in the order, what I want. So as you can see in this little simple package, there's my shifter air gauge, my plunger, my solenoid, my line, and some fittings. Well, when you order this, you can say, hey, you'll see it right there at the bottom. I need a air bottle with this. So next thing you know, you can go and they'll add on an air bottle. They'll add on just what you need to make the system work. Now, also there is a whole wiring harness kit that they also sell. I know what I'm doing electrical and I know how to hook this stuff up. With wiring it myself and splicing and soldering things together. So I don't need their wiring harness. But for a novice, I've used their wiring harness and it's plug and play. Order the thing, tell them what you need. The people that you're talking to up there on the phone, they know exactly what you need probably before you tell them because they deal with this stuff so much and they understand what you're talking about. Even though you might not know what you're talking about, they probably understand your wants when you can't describe it to them because this is what they do. And they do a good job of getting the stuff out to you in a hurry. So the other components that is needed is a air pump. You need to have a air pump. You also can order that from Snitch Racing. Okay. Now I'm going to show you a cheaper way to deal with the air pump system. And I normally just go online or on eBay and you can order a pump, just like a little air pump that you have for your car, your lawnmower, your bicycle. Okay. I simply just take this pump apart, take the pump, install it in the back of the motorcycle, and run electrical wires to a momentary switch. That's that switch I'm pushing on the side and to the battery. And voila, I have my pump hooked up on a momentary switch. When I push the switch, the pump pumps. And to give you a good idea of this, I'm going to show you one. Here's a bike. After I took that plastic container off, here's the air pump sitting right here. Here's one that I'm putting in. There's the air pump sitting right there. And you can see how easy it is. Got a positive, running over to the battery. Got a negative. That negative now is running down. See it there? The negative's running down, down, down. And remember, up under the bottom, I like to put the momentary switch over here. That's the momentary switch. There's your air pump. And now that air pump is coming out the line. And on this particular motorcycle, you can see we put a swing arm on it. He didn't want the airlines and stuff. So he wanted it all to be hidden. Well, if you can look right down there in the tank, right there. See that black bottle right there? That's his air bottle right there. It's hidden up under the tank right there. So when he hits his momentary switch, the pump pumps, boom. There's his air storage right there. And actually he's one of these guys, he's really riding on the street all the time, as you can see. So he kept his phone mount in where his air gauge would have been. So I had to build a bracket for him. And see, there's his air gauge sitting up there now. So as you can see, when I hit that momentary switch, see his air pressure go up, and that's as simple as that to hook it up on a motorcycle. So I'm going to kind of go through the basics of showing exactly everything that you need. So these are the products that you need. I told you where you can get them. And if you see, I've got a whole box of extra stuff, extra fittings. Buy as many extra fittings as you need, because you're going to use them at some point in time. And once again, I get this stuff that this, all this stuff here came from Snitch Racing. Just call up there. And like I say, they're doing this all the time. They're taking orders all the time. If you can't explain to them what you need, just tell them, hey, I've got a street bike and I want to set up a air shifter on it. And they've got a basic air shifter kit. They'll send it out to you and it should have everything on it. Now, I'll go back and say this. If you don't want to put a bottle and say still on this street bike, but you don't want a bottle, you don't need your contained air with you. You're only going to use it at the racetrack, and you want to air it up with an air tank. Well, somewhere in the line, you just put your shredder valve on there, just like an air valve for your car tire, motorcycle tire, truck tire. Put your shredder valve on there, and now, boom, you can just air it up with a carry-around air tank if you like. You don't need a pump, and you don't need a bottle. So you can also do it that way. All right. In a minute, I'm going to set some stuff up, and I'm going to come over here now to this white bike, and because the air shifter's not on here, but I'm going to kind of show, I can show now where to run the wires and how to test, what little testing things that you need to do. And I'm going to do some of this because somebody that's novice may be watching this that do not have the funding to send out to their bike to the shop and do it. I'm going to do the best that I can to show a novice person how to hook the electric up and how to make this system work. I'll be right back in 5 or 10 minutes. Okay, I'm back. And now I'm going to do this for, say, someone who's a novice trying to do this and they probably don't have really any experience with this electrical stuff. So first off, get you a tester. Get you a tester. And not only a light tester, a tester with sound that has an audible beep to it. Simply take that tester, and as you can see, I took the lead from that tester, and I've got it hooked over here to the positive on my battery. Because right now, what I'm attempting to do is, hopefully we can see that, I think so here. Right here where my hand is. This is your factory wiring harness lead to the horn. Take your tester, and you want to find out, make a determination which one is the positive and which one is the negative. Okay? So I've got the tester hooked up on my positive on the battery. If I touch right here. That's my negative, okay? So if that's my negative, that means the other one is positive. These two lead wires, and once again, these are your factory horn lead wires. These are the wires that when you press your horn button to blow the horn, it activates the negative current on this line from this factory lead. Now this is going to open up the shift valve on that shift solenoid that is on the other side of the bike down by your foot, by the plunger, that little square solenoid. So let me get around to that little solenoid, okay? So when you press the button, that sends that electrical signal through this wire, because
that shift solenoid is going to be hooked to the positive and the negative of the factory horn harness. So I'm going to go around here now. We're going to get around the bike. And let me see if I can get down where we can see it. I'm going to have to let everything down here. Bear with me for a minute. I'm going to get this down where you can see the actual... There we go. There we go. Okay. Right here, you can see I just mocked up. Here's the shift solenoid. Okay. Here's the plunger. Here's the two wires from the shift solenoid. Okay. As you can see, the red is going to be a positive. The blue is going to be a negative. Now, listen very closely. I only done this because I want to keep track of everything being positive and negative on the motorcycle. Okay? In reality, this solenoid does not care what priority it is plugged up as. It just needs a positive and a negative. It does not recognize the color of the wire. It does not recognize where you plug it up. As long as you plug it up to a positive and a negative. So in the kit, when you get the kit, when this solenoid comes out of the kit, let me run. I'm going to get a solenoid. Can you see that now? That's the solenoid when it comes out of the kit. That's what it looks like, okay? It's got two black wires on it. It does not care the priority, whether it's positive or negative. It does not care. So what that means is I run these wires up through my frame, wherever I want to run them. I am going to run these two wires all the way around the motorcycle. So now stay with me. These two wires, you're going to run them along the frame, whichever way you want to run these wires. And these two wires are going to run, and they are going to plug into now your factory horn harness for when you press your button to blow the horn. Now that's the button to activate the shift solenoid. This harness, it does not care the priority. It does not care whether it's, or correction, the shifter, the solenoid does not care. Just hook it to that harness. It doesn't care whether it's negative, positive. It does not matter. The only reason I changed the color on the wire is because I myself want to know that this is the positive side and this is definitely the negative side in the factory harness. In reality, this shift solenoid does not care. It does not care. Neither of these wires, it does not care. So what I'm saying is just hook this wire, these two wires from this solenoid, hook it to either wire from the factory harness. It does not care. It does not matter. Okay. It's still going to work. It does not care. Okay. So hopefully, I hope everybody understood that. Okay. So now you hook both of those solenoids, you hook both of these wires up to that factory horn harness. Now, this solenoid is active to work. So now, when you put air in the system, that air comes down through the line, and that air sits right here. That's why we put the air switch solenoid, we hook it directly to the plunger. Because when you air up that air tank, that air is sitting right here. Just like, you know, when you purge your nitrous, you want to bring that nitrous all the way up. So that air is sitting right here. So now as soon as I hit my air shifter button, that air is going to come out that solenoid, hit that plunger, and immediately shift my bike. Simple as that. Now, that's all the electric that you need to hook up to make this solenoid work. The solenoid does not have to be hooked there. You can put it anywhere you want to and run line there. I would just suggest to do it this way because it's easier to deal with, easier to service, so forth, so forth. Now, this is where you're going to need a little bit of, I would say, ingenuity. You're going to have to do a little, maybe machining or something. But this plunger, let's get it around there where you can see it. Yep. This air shifter plunger now, this is what's going to activate the air shifter. So once that plunger plunges, I'll get this down a little bit more where we can see it there. See if I can get there. Can we see it now? See the plunger. See if I can get it over this way. Let me tell I'm not a cameraman. That is not my forte. Okay, are we there? See my hands? Yep. There we go. I think that's the best we're going to get it. So here's my shift plunger. Yep. Here's my shift plunger now. And as you can see, I took a threaded rod. See that threaded rod? And I ran that threaded rod through the plunger, through the frame. And I'm going to show you over on Janie's bike how that's done in a minute. Matter of fact, I'll show you now. So I simply went to the hardware store, got a threaded rod, ran that threaded rod through the bolt, through the frame. Look at your frame right there. There's a bolt that goes through the frame. That holds my plunger there. Okay. I'm going to show you on the other side where that comes at. I get around the motorcycle. You see that threaded rod there? Okay. I get around there. See that threaded rod? How that threaded rod has come out of there? Okay. Now let me show you how to set that up so your plunger will be stable. If I get down here and I look, you look, where we at? That's actually a threaded rod going through there with a nylon nut. In the back, this is a rubber cushioning that is here. Then I have two other nylon lock nuts back there. So that's what keeps this in place. Now, as you can see, I can wiggle this around. Don't monkey type this thing down. This thing needs your whole plunger, the plunger itself now, not your solenoid, this, but the plunger and your foot lever and everything, leave that thing with a little bit of play so it activates, so it will operate properly. So when you shift it, it'll shift up and go down, and you can downshift and use it. If you tighten that thing up monkey tight, it's going to jam up. It's not going to work, okay? So that's just simply a threaded rod running through the factory bolt, and you got to set up your own little cushion system to make this work. But don't monkey type. If this is a little bit of play, that's great. Should have a little bit of play. And as you can see over here, I'll get around to the other side where you can see. Um,
down here. I don't like this at all, but it's the best that I got.
And here's the other side of it. Same thing. That threaded rod is coming through. And see there? There's just a nylon nut on there. And I also use a little bit of Loctite because you need this here now to be tight. But that's just a simple way of putting that on. And that'll hold that, that'll hold your plunger on there. Okay? So, let's get back over here. So now, with that being said, if you were following me, you've got your solenoid hooked up. You've got your plunger hooked up. You're going to have to do a little work. You're going to have to do a little work right here because this clevis on the end of this plunger, you can either grind that down, then drill a hole in there, but that clevis has to be mounted to this shift arm. And now I'm going to tell you now, there is a little bit of adjustment to do. Do not attempt to adjust the new shifter ram rod that's from the factory. Because really, that is what is making the auto shift, because it's already built into the bike. This solenoid is just acting like it is your foot. And it's just, when you press the button, it's just pulling up on that. Since the Hayabusa already has its own built-in quick shifter, which is really here, this is what is really shifting the bike, is the quick shifter. This solenoid is just activating enough pressure to pull the shift lever up and make the bike shift. That's it. So don't mess with this. There's a couple of bolts. There's a couple of 10 millimeter bolts to do the adjustment so you can get this at the right height. And that's why I say, if you don't have any mechanical experience, let someone else do this, because you can get yourself in a little bit of trouble and get something jammed up. Now, once that's done, we're through having the solenoid and everything hooked up as far as that. Now, of course, you got to run your lines. You have to have enough knowledge to run your air lines. And for the gauge here, the air line runs down through. You plug it in. Air line runs down. Put some protective holes on it across the motor. Would be a wise decision. And there's numerous ways to run the air lines, but that's going to be up to you. Run it around, put some protective holes on it now. If you don't put protective holes on the airline, the heat of the engine is going to deteriorate that airline and it's going to bust. And you're going to take the motorcycle all the way back apart and redo the whole thing. But that's the electrical side of it. That's how easy it is to hook up the electrical side. This other stuff, as far as the plunger, as far as the solenoid, there's numerous ways to hook it up. You can hook it up either way you want to. I'm just showing you the way that I done it. That's how easy it is to hook up an air shifter on a bike. Because now, with those items hooked up, it's simply running air line to your tank. So let me get back over here to this motorcycle here now. It's simply running your air line now throughout the bike. And now this is just the best location that I've found to put the tank. I put the tank there. I put the air compressor there. Just like I showed you, the air pump the compressors. You can buy a little cheap compressor just like this from AutoZone, or I get them off of eBay. I take the compressor apart, I take the compressor motor out, and now they normally come with, I have enough line, and in this particular bike, I have enough line to run it right over to the air tank, and I have just a shredder valve fitting, just like for a car, and I use a momentary switch on the bike that I showed you to pump up the system, and that's it. That is basically it. And so you have two electrical wires that you have to hook up from the airshift solenoid up to the horn button. That's it. The other electrical that you have to hook up will be the electrical for your momentary switch, which I'll get back over here and I'll show that again on this bike that has it. Here's your momentary switch. I put a momentary switch right there. Here's the air pump. It's hidden right here. And on this particular bike, he didn't want any air lines. He didn't have an air tank in his swing arm. So I hid the air tank. It's down up under the gas tank. There's his air tank bottle right there. So that's up to you. That's up to anybody that's doing this. There's numerous ways to hook this up. And as you can see, this is a 08 model. And so on an 08 model, he use MPS box. All this stuff from, like I say, this is all this stuff from Snitch Racing. Okay. Other than that, I don't think it's really too much else to explain about it. You just have to have some mechanical ability to basically do the job. If you don't have the mechanical ability, I would say, take it to your nearest performance center and let them do the work. I hope this helps some people out putting on an air shifter, because as you can see, it's really not that difficult. You just have to have a little bit of knowledge to do it. And actually, you could set one of these systems up in a couple of hours. And so don't get stuck at what you saw me doing and how I set it up, because there's 1,000 ways to set one of these systems up on the bike. 1,000 ways. So other than that, as I end all my videos, because I'm going to hook this system up on this bike right now for real, in all my videos, bye-bye. Just something that I just wanted to add on to the back of this video, a few interesting things that I'd mentioned it before in a video when I was putting together that first 2022. If you notice this counter sprocket cover on this new bike, it's just a big piece of plastic. It has two bolts that's in it. And when you take that big piece of plastic off, look at the size of that aluminum piece that they made. This thing circumferences the entire. And the only reason I can, and I mean, it is a big, thick piece of aluminum. And the only reason I could think that they put that big piece of aluminum in there like that is, was due to chain breakage. Because normally when the chain broke, and it was in the right spot, that counter sprocket would pull that chain in there, run through, and bust the back of the case on the motor. Just destroy that case. Well, that means you just lost the motor. So they've encased this big, thick piece of aluminum. I mean, it goes all the way back on the motor. It goes all the way down. It goes all the way in front of the
it's going to be hard for that chain to get through there and knock that out. You still got that little part of the fuel pump that it would break, but I'd rather have it break that fuel pump and not bust that case. So that was something that was interesting I wanted to show. And another thing on these bikes is this fly-by-wire system. As you can see, there's the... Remember on the old throttle bodies, so you would have that. Here's your throttle. Here's my throttle cables here. Coming from the throttle. And normally this deal here was on the side of the throttle bodies itself. So when you open the throttle, which is opening the gas, the throttle body butterflies opened up because this was on the side of the throttle. Well, now this system here is a fly-by-wire system. I did do a little adjustment to it because Janie was complaining about on her bike it not seeming to be responsive enough. So I did do a little adjustment in here and got the thing to be a little bit, got the throttle to feel more tension, or she could have better feel. But it's fly by wire because, as you can see, I can take and turn the throttle and see it. So if I turn the throttle wide open, you can see that thing wide open. So there it is closed, there it is wide open. But if you look inside your air box now, there's nothing. It's all fly-by-wire. Them blades aren't even... Those blades don't move anymore now. It's all fly-by-wire, and it's like it's on its own little... It's got its own little computer sitting right here. So there's the wires that come out of it, and that's going to be something probably to deal with. It's a little flimsy thing, too. Look, it... I like my Hayabusas, but man, that is, look how that, I mean, I'm just touching it with my, look right here. I'm just touching it with my finger and that thing will move around. It's the flimsiest thing I've seen, but I ever seen on the, I'll just say this. As long as it works, that's great, because if they spent the money to protect the engine and they, you know, skimped and scamped over here a little bit, I'm satisfied. But it's the flimsiest little thing. But it's all fly-by-wire now. So that there is something that was interesting. I don't know if people knew or not. Remember they had both the injectors previously down in the throttle bodies. Well, the injectors now, there's the other injectors. They're sitting right in the top of the air box, shooting straight down in there. So there's the other injectors to the bike. Other than that, sure, it's got a lot more different electrical components on it, but I just thought that those two or three things was kind of interesting. Those, and of course, you know, there's the new ABS system and all that stuff that's sitting in there. But anyway, that's just some new interesting stuff that's basically on the bike. Anyway, bye-bye. Video world, I'm going to read from the actual Suzuki service manual. What this quick shift system actually kind of details. It says it's a bi-directional quick shift system for up and down shifts without using the clutch or throttle operation. It says general shifter sensor on the gear shift linkage monitors the gear shift level motion, and the ECU controls the ignition timing, the throttle valve opening, and the fuel injection volume to be injected. So basically,
What it's saying is that on the upshift and the downshift, the ECU controls three functions. It controls the ignition timing, the throttle valve opening, and the fuel injection, all through the ECU. Only thing I can say is that I don't feel that I have the knowledge to interfere with this factory system. So I would just, this is for me now. I set the air shifter up just to shift the shift lever. I'm not even gonna even attempt to go into the factory system. I'm not even gonna attempt that. I'm be satisfied with where I'm at, because one thing that I do know for sure, that there's two modes. They have one mode that they call a sport mode. The second shift mode is called a city mode. We've only tried the sport mode. And in that sport mode, that's where it has that little, what you would say, the exhaust gases or fuel gets reignited, makes that little pop every time the shift button is hit. I believe now that's probably due to the volume of fuel that is still being injected into the system. And once that timing is killed, those spark plugs come back to fire and they ignite that unburnt fuel that's in the combustion chamber. Pow, get that pop, because it's just a nice, smooth little pop. It's not like that nitrous, bang, it's that nice, just a nice little pop. I'm gonna leave this system alone, and here's the main reason I'm gonna leave it alone. I think these engineers would have had to do a whole lot of work to get the system to work. And I believe that we've run the bike enough now. And this bike set on this sport mode has not missed a shift. It has not binded up the transmission. It has not, it's done nothing but shift flawless. I'm not changing anything. I'm leaving this system just like it is in place from the factory, leaving it through the, I'm not even going to attempt to change anything on the ECU. I don't have that type of experience. So I'm leaving this thing just like this. And, I know this bike is running consistent with it, and that's what I'm looking for. So I'm happy with it the way it is from the factory. And I'm just going to let that little shift solenoid that we get from Snitch Racing and that plunger, and I'm just going to leave it hooked to that factory shifter for my upshifts and press that button. And I'm going to let that factory quick shift system run through the ECU and do its thing, because it's been working like a dream. And it has not failed me, has not missed any shifts, has not binded the transmission. It has not done anything but work. So I'm happily satisfied with it. I'm gonna make a screenshot of what I just read. I'm gonna make the screenshot of the manual so that everyone can see for themselves. And if you do have one of these and you read through your owner's manual, the owner manual does explain to you that there is two shifter modes for this quick shifter. Mode 1 is a sport mode. Mode 2 is a city, they're just calling it a citywide mode. So it's supposed to be just, I assume, to shift a lot smoother as you're going through the city. I don't know, haven't used it yet, and actually haven't ridden a bike in the city or off the street, only at the racetrack. So it's only been in sport mode. So with that being said, I hope this video helps some people out. Hope they are able to hook this shifter up themselves and do this work. And good luck. And only thing I can say is bye-bye.